So, good morning, students. So, yesterday we had completed around 40 questions. So, today we will complete this chapter by solving 20 more questions. So, this is the 41st question. So, let's see about the 41st question. See here, what is the question over here means? So, that is match the two columns and select the correct among options given below. Okay, match the two columns and select the correct among options given below. Okay, see here, first of all, bio macromolecules of food. Okay, here some options are there which are basic questions. Okay, bio macromolecules of food, human digestive system, stomach, thecodont, serosa. Here, alimentary canal and associated gland, then embedded in jaws of bones, outer wall of visceral organs, converted into simple substances, J-shaped bag-like structure. So, first you see here, bio macromolecules. Macromolecules means these are the food substances which has to be broken down. Okay, broken down into what? Simpler substances. In the definition of digestion, what is the definition of digestion means? That is the breakdown of complex food molecules into the simpler absorbable form in food substances. So what is that biomacromolecules? That is that should be converted into simple substances. Okay, this is a correct match for what? That is bio macromolecules of food that has to be converted to into simple substances. So, see, what is the A1 means? A is matched with the option 4. Okay, A matched with the option 4. The next, second option, B option, human digestive system. Human digestive system, that is also known as the alimentary canal and associated gland. See, human digestive system is composed of alimentary canal or gut also we can say. So these option match with the first option, that is alimentary canal and associated gut. Here, the human digestive system, that is esophagus, stomach, small intestine, large intestine, all they are what? If they are in the form of canal. So, that is the alimentary canal. And associated gland means there are several glands such as gastric glands, intestinal glands, then liver, pancreas, these all are what? Glands. So, that we can call it as the human digestive system. Then stomach. Stomach means which is J-shaped bag-like structure. Here I will show you how the stomach. Yesterday also you had studied about the parts, different parts of the stomach. This is the J-shaped bag-like structure. J-shaped. Okay. J-shaped somewhat bag-like structure. That is the stomach. So which is that one? C is the fifth option. C matches with the fifth option. Then thecodont. Yesterday, in the first class itself, I told you, thecodont in a man, they possess N different types of teeth. That is, first thing, that is diphyodont. During their lifetime, there are two types of, they have the two sets of teeth. One is milk or temporary teeth, and the second is the permanent teeth. And the second thing, that is the thecodont type of teeth. Thecodont means the teeth which are embedded in the socket of jaw. So that is D option matches with the second option. Okay, the next, serosa. Serosa, what it is? In the four muscular layer of alimentary canal, there are four wall layers, serosa, submucosa, mucosa, and one more is there, that is muscularis layer. So serosa is the outer wall of visceral organs. So see, first biomacromolecules is matching with the fourth option, A4, human digestive system, First, stomach, J-shaped bag-like structure. Okay. Then thecodont, that is embedded in the socket of jaw. Serosa, outer wall of visceral organ. So A is the fourth one. Here you see in the options A 4. In the second option you see A is 4, B is the first, C is the fifth one, D is the second one, and E is the third one. So which is the correct option means that is the second option is the correct option. So let's go for the next question. 42nd question. Which one of the following pairs of the kinds of cells and their secretion is correctly matched? Let's see here. See what the question is. Following pairs of kind of cells. Okay. And their secretion is correctly matched. The cells, their secretions, which are going to be correctly matched. Auxentic cells. Okay. A secretion with pH between 2.02 and 3.0. Here, auxentic cells, which are one of the type of cells of what? Gastric gland. So here, auxentic cells, so these auxentic cells are a type of what? Gastric, which are present in the gastric gland. Gastric gland. So here, these auxentic cells are going to secrete an hydrochloric acid whose pH is acidic. Acidic means that is about 2.0 and 3.0 in between this one. Yes, first is correctly matching. Next, we will go for the second. Alpha cells of islet of Langerhans. Islet of Langerhans. See, what do you mean by this islet of Langerhans? Let's see. Islets of Langerhans. See, in the alimentary canal, there is a presence of what? Pancreas. What it is present? That is the pancreas. Pancreas has two types of cells. That is, pancreas will act as two systems. Okay. First is exocrine and one more, that is endocrine. I think you know the meaning of exocrine and endocrine. The secretion through the without duct exocrine, with duct, that is the endocrine system. So the pancreas will act as both, that is exocrine and endocrine. Here during exocrine, they are going to secrete the there is a presence of cells. That cells are known as the pancreatic acini. What it is known as? They are known as the pancreatic acini. So this pancreatic acini is responsible for release of a juice that helps in the digestion, that is known as the pancreatic juice. The secretor. So exocrine means which? All over the pancreas are made up of two types of cell. That is, first is islet of Langerhans, and second is the pancreatic acini. Pancreatic acini. Okay, so these pancreatic acini will secrete the pancreatic juice. While they are acting as an endocrine system, means they secrete. Whatever the secretion they are going to secrete, that is going to through ducts. So what is that through ducts? What it is going to secrete means endocrine system. It consists of a group of cells that is known as the islet of Langerhans. That human pancreas has about 1 million of islet of Langerhans. So what is the role? It consists of numerous secretes. This islet of Langerhans will secretes and hormones. So these hormones are circulating into the blood. So this islet of Langerhans are also of two types. That is alpha cells and one more, that is beta cells. Beta cells. What is the role of these alpha cells and beta cells? Means alpha cells are what they are going to do means they are they also secrete certain hormones, but the hormones which are secreting through the alpha cells, they circulate in the blood at the periphery region, not in the central region. But this whatever these beta cells are going to produce, the secretion that is going to circulate at the central region, and which hormones they are going to secrete means that is the insulin. Which hormone they are going to secrete? That is the insulin is going to hormone. The role of insulin is that is it converts the glucose into glycogen. What they will do? They will convert the glucose into glycogen. This conversion of glucose into glycogen takes place in the liver and muscles. So what they are telling, and one more thing they had given, alpha cells or islet of Langerhans secretion that decrease the blood sugar level. See, they are this islet of Langerhans will secrete the hormone that is the insulin. What is the role, what is the function of insulin? Means that converts the glucose into glycogen, that is in the liver and muscles. This deficiency of insulin, if insulin is going to decrease or if insulin is going to lower down in the blood, what is going to happen means a disease is going to take place, that is a diabetes mellitus. What is going to take place? That is the diabetes mellitus, or deficiency of insulin is going to take place, the diabetes mellitus. Okay, deficiency. So what they are telling, secretion that decrease blood sugar level. Okay, but here the thing is that due to the secretion from alpha cells of islet of Langerhans, that does not decrease the blood sugar level, but it will, due to the deficiency of insulin, the blood sugar level is going to increase in the blood because the glucose is going to increase. This is not going to convert into glycogen, and so that's why diabetes mellitus will take place when there is a deficiency. When there is an increase or there is an more amount of insulin, means at that time that blood sugar level is going to be decreased. So this is the wrong option. Kupffer cells, I told you, this is a these are the cells which are present in the liver. So they are not going to secrete any digestive enzymes. Sebaceous gland, sebaceous gland is the oil gland. Okay, oil gland which provide the lubrication to the skin. But here they had given a function of sweat gland, not of sebaceous gland, a secretion that evaporates for cooling. So that is doing, this is the function of whom? That is of the what we call sweat gland. So this is also wrong option, this is also wrong option. Which option is the correct one? That is the oxyntic cells. The next 43rd question. Duodenum has characteristic Brunner's gland which secrete two hormones called, okay, here what we call that is the duodenum. Duodenum has this Brunner's gland. What is the role of this Brunner's gland, sir? Let's see. See this Brunner's gland is going to secrete a hormone, sir. And what are that hormones, sir? Let's see. Brunner's gland. Brunner's gland will secrete the hormone secretin, and one more hormone, that is cholecystokinin. Okay, these are the two hormone which is going to secrete two hormones. Okay, this is the gland, Brunner gland, which is located in duodenum. It secretes two hormones, secretin and a second cholecystokinin. So secretin, what is the role of secretin? Means it releasing from the Brunner's gland, but it is going to act on whom? Means it acts on pancreas, liver, and stomach. Pancreas, liver, and stomach. Here, polycytokinin will act on small intestine, where they are going to act. That is on the small intestine. Then next, what is the function of this secretin? Means it releases. It releases bicarbonates in a pancreatic juice. This is the first function of what? Of this is secretin. Except this, it also increases secretion of bile. Okay, it also increases the secretion because it acting on whom? On the liver. Okay. While they are acting on pancreas, it releases bicarbonate, certain salts into the pancreatic juice. While they are acting on liver, they will increase the secretion of bile. And while they are act on the stomach, at that time, it decreases gastric secretions. Gastric secretions. These are the three roles of what? Of hormone secretin, which is going to secrete from the Brunner's gland, which is located in the duodenum. Except this, polycytokinin acts on the small intestine, so where it contracts the gallbladder. Contracts gallbladder to secrete bile juice, as well as it also acts on the pancreas to secrete pancreatic juice. Okay, so this is about what? Brunner's gland. So which is the correct option over here? Means they are given prolactin. Okay, this is one of the hormone which is going to help, which acts on the secretion of milk from the mammary glands. Then parathyroid hormone, estradiol, progesterone. Progesterone, it is one of the female hormone or which is related with the female reproductive system, which helps in maintaining the pregnancy. Kinase, estrogen, this is also one of the reproductive hormone. Here, secretin and polycytokinin. So fourth option is the correct option. Next, we will go for the next question. That is a 44th question. You see here. Here you see 44th question. Which one of the following is correctly matching or correct matching of the site of action on given substrate? Here they had given some of the sites, some of the parts of the digestive system. Okay, there we have to match them, the enzymes. Okay, according to the different parts or sites, they had given the enzyme names and acting upon it and the what is the end product. So let's see here. First one, that is stomach. In stomach, the fats are going to convert it into lipase, then which will convert into the measles. See here, fats in the presence of an enzyme lipase. Okay, fats in the presence of an enzyme lipase is going to convert into the measles. Here, whatever the fat digestion is there, that is not going to take place in the stomach. That is going to take place in the small intestine. So this is the wrong option, small intestine. And one more thing, they had given the measles. Measles means small droplets of the fat molecules. So that we can also call it as the emulsified fat. Emulsified fats. So this also we cannot say directly it is going to convert it into the emulsified fat. Fat in the presence of bile juice. Okay, fat in the presence of bile juice is going to convert into the meatus. Okay, this is also wrong thing or wrong reaction about a wrong byproduct. Next, second one, duodenum. They had given duodenum in duodenum. Okay, in duodenum, triglycerides. Triglycerides in the presence of an enzyme that is the trypsin converted into monoglycerides. Okay, in duodenum they had given whatever the triglyceride and monoglyceride are there, they are also triglyceride and monoglyceride means where there is a presence of this also takes place not in the duodenum region. That is, yes, they are, this will take place in the duodenum region. But the thing is that this triglyceride in the presence of an enzyme trypsin is going to convert into monoglyceride they had given. But in the presence of trypsin, that is not going to convert. Trypsin is the enzyme to convert the protein molecules. So here, triglycerides are going to convert into pancreatic lipase. This is the name of enzyme. So here the enzyme name is wrong. And next, small intestine starch alpha amylase is converted into what? That is the maltose or disaccharide. Here it's not going to take place yes, it's going to take place in the small intestine, but the thing is that it is going to not only going to take convert into maltose, but also it also going to convert into the isomaltose plus dextrin. So these are the byproducts. So this also we cannot say whether it is a right or wrong option. So here, see, byproduct they had given the maltose, but they had not given the isomaltose or dextrin. But whatever the byproduct they had given, that byproduct is correct. Yes, it is taking place in the small intestine, that is starch in the presence of alpha amylase, that is going to convert into the disaccharide maltose. This is the correct option. Then last one, small intestine proteins pepsin is going to convert it into what? That is in the amino acid. Here directly this pepsin is not going to convert into the amino acid, but here that is going to convert into in the presence of carboxypeptidases. First they will convert, these proteins are going to convert into large peptides. Proteins are going to convert into large peptides. Then these large peptides in the presence of an enzyme carboxypeptidase, that is going to convert into dipeptides plus amino acids. This is the correct reaction for the last option. So this is also wrong option. Next, we will go for the 45th question. Here in the 45th question, you see what will happen if secretion of parietal cells of gastric glands is blocked. Okay, see here. What will happen if the secretion of parietal cells, okay, of gastric gland is blocked? First, we will see what is the role of this parietal cells. Parietal cells are also known as the oxyntic cells. What they are also known as? They are also known as the oxyntic cells. See, parietal cells which secretes the HCl, hydrochloric acid, as well as one more thing, that is the castile intrinsic factor. Okay, so here you see, if this HCl is going to block, what is going to happen within an inhibitor? So here in the 45th question, you see in the options, you see what are the options means enterokinase will not be released from the duodenal mucosa. Enterokinase will not be released from the duodenal mucosa. See, enterokinase is one of the enzyme which inhibit the gastric juices from the gastric glands. Will not be released from the duodenal. See, the enterokinase is not going to mucosa, and so trypsinogen is not converted to trypsin. There is no relation of enterokinase. What is the main function of enterokinase? Means enterokinase will inhibit the secretion of gastric juices from the gastric glands. It is not involved in the conversion of trypsinogen to trypsin. So this is the wrong option. Then gastric juice will be deficient in chymosin. Okay. If parietal cells are not going to secrete the HCl, then what they are telling, then gastric juice is going to be deficient. We cannot say that the gastric juice will not going to be deficient. So this is also a wrong option. Gastric juice will be deficient in the pepsinogen. This will not affect to the pepsinogen or trypsinogen. This is also wrong option. The next, lastly, in the absence of HCl secretion, here they had given the correct option. You see, first of all, if parietals are going to secrete the HCl, if it is blocked, there will be no secretion of the HCl. This will inactivate the pepsinogen. Okay, inactive pepsinogen is not converted into active enzyme, that is the pepsin. So this is the correct option. The next 46th question: when breastfeeding is replaced by less nutritive food, low in proteins and calories, the infant below the age of 1 year are likely to be suffer from. See here, one term I want to explain, that is PEM, protein energy malnutrition. PEM, that is protein energy malnutrition. Here you see protein energy malnutrition, due to the deficiency of proteins, the malnutrition means certain children will be there with them. There is a deficiency of nutrients, that is known as the malnutrition. So whatever the growing child needs the more proteins for their growth and development. If protein energy malnutrition leads to, if there is an protein energy malnutrition deficiency, or there is a deficiency of proteins, it will give rise to two types of diseases, that is kwashiorkor and one more, that is the marasmus. Okay, kwashiorkor means due to the deficiency of protein in diet. Deficiency of protein in a diet, this will lead to the disease kwashiorkor. And marasmus is a disease which is caused by the deficiency of deficiency of proteins as well as calories. Okay, calories, if there is deficiency of calories also, then there will be a marasmus is going to take place. So here what they are telling, you see, replaced by less nutritive food means that is less in calories, less in proteins, and low in proteins and calories, both they had given. If only they had given the proteins, means we can say that disease is the kwashiorkor. and the infants below the age of 1 year are likely to be suffer from the marasmus. What is the correct option? That is the marasmus. Then come to 47th question. You see, 47th question. A young infant may be feeding entirely on mother's milk, which is white in color, but the stools which the infant passes out is quite yellowish. What is the yellow color due to? See, you carefully understand the question. Young infant, okay, that is about 2 to 1 to 1.5 years or 2 years. Okay, you take it. Feeding entirely on mother's milk. Okay, entirely. They will not eat any food. They will not eat any fruits and all. Just on the mother's milk they are surviving. So mother's milk will be white in color. But the stools which the infant passes out. Okay, if so much small infant is there, if he is drinking only mother's milk which is white in color, then whatever the stools, whatever the fecal matter they are going to release, that should be also in white in color. Why it is in quite yellowish color? What is the yellow color due to? That is due to the first option, undigested milk. Okay, if there is an undigestion of milk, then the child will suffer from the child will suffer from some stomach pain like that. And the protein casein, this we cannot say. Pancreatic juice poured into the duodenum. See, first of all, pancreatic juices are not going to be secreted in whom? In the small child. Then next, intestinal juice, that is also, then bile pigment passes through the bile juice. Yes, due to this bile juices in the stomach, in the intestine, the color of the stools will be yellowish in color. So this is about what? 47th question. Next we will go for the 48th question. You see, statement common to amylase, renin and trypsin is that. Okay, renin and amylase, renin and trypsin, they are telling here. You see, statement common to amylase, renin and trypsin is that. These are all proteins. Okay. Second, these are produced in stomach. We cannot say they are producing in the stomach. Here amylase is produced in the saliva. Okay. Which is secreting from the salivary gland. And salivary glands are located in the oral cavity or the mouth. And renin and trypsin are not going to secrete in the trypsin is secreting from the gastric juices, but renin, that is through the what we call intestinal juices. So these act on pH lower than 7. That also we cannot say. And here trypsin is going to activate, trypsinogen is going to convert it into trypsin, which is in the inactive form. So trypsin will be in the active form. So that is the trypsinogen is going to convert into trypsin in the when they will come in contact or action with the HCl, whose pH is 2 to 2.5. So these also we cannot say. These are all proteolytic enzymes. No, these are proteolytic enzymes. They are not proteolytic enzymes. So what is the correction? These all are proteins. The next 49th question, you see, glucose and amino acids are mainly absorbed in the intestine by. Here they had given 4 options. That is what we call osmosis, co-transport, passive transport, and diffusion. One more meaning for the co-transport is the, or one more name for the co-transport is the facilitated transport. what it is? Facilitated transport. Here you see glucose and amino acids are mainly absorbed in the intestine. Okay, then how they are going to be absorbed? Here I will tell you. Absorption of some nutrients along with all these options, that is the simple diffusion. There are certain physical factors are there in this absorption of nutrients into the small intestine. So through the simple diffusion, which nutrients are going to be absorbed in the small intestine means that is fatty acids and glycerols. The next second one, through osmosis means that is water. Third one, facilitated transport means that is carbohydrate and amino acids. Okay, active transport means only the salts. So here you see by osmosis what is going to transport it, that is the water. Okay, then co-transport or facilitated transport means that is carbohydrate. Glucose is one of the carbohydrate and amino acids. So which option is the correct one? That is the facilitated. And through osmosis water is going to be transported, and through active transport salts are going to be transported. Then next, the absorption of glycerol, fatty acids and monoglycerides takes place by the colon. See, in the colon means which is a part of large intestine, in the colon only water are going to be absorbed. So this is the wrong option. Wall of the stomach are not going to absorb, they are going to secrete the gastric juices. Capillaries within the villi, this also we cannot say. Lymph vessels within the villi. So this is the correct option, 51. Then come to the next question, 51st question, that is the fats are absorbed fats are absorbed from the gut, that is from the alimentary canal, are transported to the blood in the form of, in which form they are going to be transported. Here there are certain options. First, measles, liposomes, chylomicrons and chemomicrons. Let's see here, whatever the fatty acids and glycerols will be there, fatty acids and glycerols are there, and certain fat soluble vitamins. Fat soluble vitamins will be there. They reach the blood directly. Okay, into the bloodstream they will reach directly. Okay, the next term. Then it is incorporated. Whatever the fatty acids, glycerol or vitamins are there, they are going to incorporated into small droplets. In which form they are going to change? That is in the small droplets. And the droplets, whatever the fat soluble they are, or they are the fat molecules, that will convert into the water soluble. So this water soluble water droplets, small droplets, we can call it them it as the measles. Still they are not transported to the blood, but these measles are going to, from the measles, in these measles there will be presence of fatty acids, glycerols and fat soluble vitamins. Okay, So this all incorporation of into small droplets of water soluble, this all will take place in the lumen of intestine. The next term here, these all are absorbed into intestinal cells. Whatever these measles are there, these are going to absorbed into intestinal cells by which process means that is by diffusion. And these whatever after absorption, these are going to convert into very small fat molecules, and that fat molecules will be in the form of droplets, and these we can call it as the chylomicrons. So in which form they are going to converted first into the measles, then into the chylomicrons, then they are going to be absorbed into what? Into the bloodstream. So here, which are the correct option? Which is the correct option? Chylomicrons. Next, 52nd question. You see, absorption of salt and water. Absorption of salt and water is the principal function of which region of the gastrointestinal tract? Okay, salt and water they had given. Jejunum, stomach; duodenum, large intestine. Jejunum is the part of small intestine, stomach, as you know, J-shaped structure, duodenum and large intestine, they are telling. So which is the correct option over here means, so in which part this salt and water are going to be absorbed means, that is in the large intestine. Whatever the remaining water will be there in the food, waste food, that is going to be absorbed by whom? By the large intestine. The juice containing sodium glycolate is released under the influence of, okay, that is third one, that is sodium glycolate, that is going to be released from this cholecystokinin. Let's see, cholecystokinin is one of the hormone which is going to released under the influence of what? The sodium glycosylate is going to released under the influence of cholecystokinin. The next come to the question number 54th. Function of enterogastron is, enterogastron I told you before only that it will inhibit the secretion of gastric. So first I will explain about the enterogastron, which is one of the hormone that is also known as the gastric inhibitory peptide. Okay, so this is secreting, enterogastron is secreted from which part means, that is duodenum. Okay, so it will secrete it from the duodenum and act on whom? It will act on stomach. What is the main function? It's acting on the stomach means, here they inhibit gastric secretion. You see here, function of enterogastron, regulation of flow of bile, that is not correct, inhibition of gastric secretion. Okay, yes, this is the correct option. The next term, which of the following is the correct match? 55th question, you see, which of the following is the correct match vitamin B6? This is a pyridoxine which is found in the whole grain, cereals, peanuts, bananas and all. It helps in the protein metabolism. okay, protein metabolism. Vitamin B12, vitamin B12 is also known as a cyanocobalamin. Vitamin, here I will write vitamin B12, which is also known as not thiamine. This is wrong. Not thiamine. That is cyanocobalamin. Okay, cyanocobalamin, which is present in the spirulina, that is in the algae, as well as some of the animal source, means that present in the liver, meat, fish, egg, milk, etc. What is the role of this cyanocobalamin? Means it helps in the RBC production. What is the function of the cyanocobalamin or vitamin B12? That is the RBC production. Then vitamin B1 is there. Vitamin B1 is the thiamine. It is also known as the thiamine, which is present in the whole grain, wheat, germ, legumes, nuts, fishes and all. It is essential for repair and growth of tissues. Repair and growth of tissues. Okay, so here, which is the correct option? That is, cyanocobalamin should be here, thiamine should be here, and last option is all of the above. So all are not correctly matching. Which is the correct matching? Vitamin B6, that is the pyridoxin. Next, 56th question. You see, if for some reasons our goblet cells are non-functional, this will adversely affect what, to whom, to which part it is affecting? Let's see. See, goblet cells are responsible to secrete the mucus. Okay. If that goblet cells become non-functional, if they stop to secrete the mucus, what is going to happen? To which part it is going to be affected? First thing, smooth movement of food down the intestine. Okay. Production of somatostatin. See, somatostatin, which is a hormone, this is not going to be released, secreted from the goblet cells. Secretion of sebum. Sebum means that is the earwax. Here there is no relation of earwax with the digestive or alimentary canal from the sebaceous gland, they are telling. Then next, maturation of sperm. Here maturation of sperms are also not related with the goblet cell. Mucus helps in the it will become non-functional. It will affect to the smooth movement of food down from the stomach to the intestine. So first option is the correct option. Next, we will go for the 57th question. You see here, that is which one of the following enzyme carries out the initial step in the digestion of milk in human? Okay, so what is the correct option over here? Means that is pepsin in the adult, renin in the small child. Anxiety and eating spicy food together in otherwise normal human may lead to, okay, so anxiety and eating spicy food may lead to the what, to which disease or to which condition it is going to lead? Means that is to the indigestion. Then if for some reason the parietal cells of the gut epithelium become partially non-functional. Parietal cell, already I told you, which is another name for oxygenic cell, which will secrete the HCl. What is likely to be happen? Okay, so here what is going to be happen means proteins will not adequately hydrolyzed by pepsin into proteases and peptones. This is the correct option. Jaundice is a disorder of what? That is the digestive system. Jaundice means here it is secreting, see, whatever the bile pigments which are secreting from the, what we call that is from the bile juice which is present in the bile juice. So it is a disorder, jaundice, it is a disorder of liver. Disorder of liver. Here, what is going to happen means, in jaundice, the skin and eyes turns yellow. Due to what? Why it is going to convert it into yellow means, due to large quantity of large quantities of bilirubin pigment. Okay, so this is about what? About the jaundice. So here the digestive system chapter, digestion and absorption chapter completes. So tomorrow we will go with the next chapter, that is the respiration or respiratory gases. So tomorrow be prepared with the respiratory gases or respiration chapter, that is a breathing and exchange of gases. Okay, it is the second chapter of human physiology. So be thorough with that chapter. I'm going to start tomorrow with the breathing and exchange of gases or respiratory system. Okay, thank you.